guys, it's episode 146. I went to Curry's and found a really beautiful set of markers. I've never heard of this brand because I don't normally go to Curry's, but I went to a really far away one. It's like in Richmond Hill or farther than Richmond Hill. It's like Markham, but a little bit farther. It's kind of halfway towards Vaughn Mills. But when I was searching it up, that's the only thing that I know, but it's like near a movie theater, and they have like, it's a small plaza thing that's surrounded, that has the movie theater combined with it. So it's really, really, it's a really kind of strange place to find an art store, in my opinion, but it's pretty good thing because you can't really find that much art stores near my house because I'm in Mississauga. But the other ones that are far, like in Toronto, are really good, and I've heard stuff like Above Ground Arts and stuff. That one's also another good place to find art supplies, but I haven't checked it out because they're all in Toronto, and to be honest, I'm probably only going to go once in a while for art supplies now because I found a really cheap, I found decent pricing for some of the outlining markers that I want, so I'll probably go there. So here's what the packaging looks like. It's so beautiful. Like, there's another set with a few, with more colors, but with more different gradients and everything. But for now, I'm just sticking with this because I'm still testing the waters with different markers, and I'm not really so good with markers in shading. But yeah, it's 30. There's like a whole bunch of different colors. I think it comes with some supplies where you can make like different mixes. I'm not sure. I haven't fully looked at it. But it's so pretty, and these are like the numbers that they have. And this is actually from Chameleon Color Tones. I've never heard of this company because I use touch markers. The only other thing I've heard of is Copic markers, but those are really pricey. So I don't want to get those. I might not. I was thinking in the future I might get some, but because it's really pricey, I might not go for it. And here is what the back looks like. So that's what the set looks like when you open it. It's like, it's a carrying case, and it has like tweezers and different things. So you can make your different mixes of colors to blend and stuff, and that's really cool, but I'm probably gonna do that way later because I've never done this in my life. But also, I'm not sure. I think this could be also useful for if you want to. I'm not sure if these markers are refillable. If you guys know if like different markers, like artist markers, are refillable, please tell me, because right now, I sort of am seeing the price ranges, and I want to kind of know if, like, I can reuse these. Just because it comes in, like, capsules and stuff, and I don't want to, like, throw it out if there's a way to refill. But if there's not, I'll just buy, like, new ones every time. So this is actually a 30 marker set. It was $120 to $50. I can't remember, but it's in the range of $120 to $50. So, dollars. The larger one is $250 or so. I don't fully remember, but I remember the ranges. It's kind of hard to see because it's all black, but the name is engraved on here, Chameleon Color Tones, and the logo is too. This is kind of hard to see too because it's black, but they have a strap. It's a kind of adjustable, like right here, and it's such a nice carrying case, but I don't suggest carrying this in the water because it feels like a board that you can ruin over time. So cover this if you're going outside. But basically, it's held up by the strap itself, so it doesn't fall apart, and then you just pull it. I'm gonna do this off camera because it's really difficult to do this. Sorry for the sound it makes. Because it's such a tight box, it makes squeaking sounds. Second. It's a really nice box though. It's really tight and compact, so everything's in there. So, okay. It's hard to see because of the lighting. I will flip it over like this so you guys can see the colors. It's really pretty. Like, I've never seen sets like this. From Touch Markers, they only have like really small sets, and I'm pretty sure they're really pricey if you want to get all of them, but Chameleon Color Tones also has like small sets, so you get different shades, like different shades of red, different shades of blue, different shades of skin tones, and yeah, you can also buy those separately from each other completely. So you can see all of this is just really pretty. It's all just packed in there nicely. There's tape on it though, so I will have to take that off later. There is a pamphlet. So it basically just tells you about how you can use it, the different tips, and how you can, if you're struggling with your first time using it, there's different ways to get it to go well, and also there's two different things. So there's a detail pen, which I don't have. That's more of an outlining an accent stamping thing, which it says right here, I'm writing off, but I did get the colorist blender pen. I will try to use that for future use. So there is a refill thing, so I will go and search that up and read about it more. Multiple color tones, so there's that type of mixing thing, which is really cool. But since I'm probably going to do that way later because I'm still new to this, but this set is pretty good if you want to start off like just with basic colors, and then later you can go into more detail and get the one that has like, how much was it? I think it's 50 or more than 50. I believe it's more than 50 colors, but that one is good if you like, you're already skilled. So that's why I only got the basic colors, because I don't want to buy so much and then end up messing up. Like, because I'm still testing, I don't want to mess up my drawings, so I might just try and see how I do, and when I get more skilled with blending, I'll go in back and buy something like that. Also, it's good because you're testing, you don't want to use a lot of money on stuff until you know you're good with it. So that's why I sort of stray away from really expensive stuff first. A lot of this I'll probably just read up on how to do and also self-teach myself, so that way I know how to use it because I don't go to an art school to learn how to use these things. Like, a lot of people on YouTube do, like, they're self-taught, so that's really nice to know that there are other people who are self-taught, because it's really hard to find people who will. I think it's really nice to see them on YouTube, so that way you get an understanding of how to use it, and you're basically teaching yourself how to use it. At the same time, you're looking at how other people use it, so you gain your own type of techniques. So there's instructional videos and everything. I will check this out more later. And so, apparently this one has all the accessories. Oops, kind of ripped it. It's okay. Trying to figure out how to open this. Okay, so as you can see, it comes with tweezers. And then we have a bunch. I'm not gonna open it now, but it's a bunch of the refillable mixing. The refillable blank ones, so you can like mix and match different tones together, which is really nice. But yeah, those are the accessories that come with it. Now the blending markers and pens come separately, so you have to buy that separately. And I don't remember the cost. I really wish I remembered the cost. Not sure, but you guys can look it up if you want. It's just search up Chameleon color tones. You can search up the detail pen and the colorist blender pen, and you should be able to find it. So, focus. So, these two, and I think they're really good for this, and also you can see it like lightens it up, so that's really nice. What I mean by basic colors is, so this is what I mean by basic colors. So like you have your rainbow colors like pink, red, orange, yellow, green to blue and indigo, which is basic rainbow colors. And then you have like some purples, some skin colors, some browns and grays. I don't know why this doesn't have black, but I guess I shouldn't be using a black for. I'm not sure. But I will test. I want to kind of test out like the gray, the darker grays, because they come off really dark. I want to test and see if that worked out better than just using like a black marker. But if it doesn't turn out the way I want it, I will change back to. I will go and find a black one separately. But for now, this is all I need. But it's such a. As I said before, this is such a beautiful case. I've never seen anything like it, and if it's like, it's not my first time using art markers, but I'm still in the process of learning, so the basic colors are really good for that, and like I have so much variety, more variety than I have with my other basic color sets from different companies like Desires and Touch markers. I feel that their basic color sets only include the color of the rainbows, and it's really hard to kind of blend if you only have a few colors. But yeah, I think this is really, as I keep repeating myself over and over again, but it's a stunning set, especially if you're just learning, and then you can move on to the $200.50 one. That one has way more different, like more, they probably have more pinks, more reds, blues, greens, yellows, different varieties of shades, which is really nice too. But this is really nice for a beginner. I mean, I feel that it's cheaper to buy this set instead of going on and buying different ones, because standard costs or cheapest would be $5 individual to maybe, I think I saw $8 or $9 for a more expensive brand. So having that said, if you're looking for kind of like a more like a good price to vary from, I would say this one is a pretty good decent price. It's not that expensive, because if you buy this many colors with standard ones, usually cost $7, and those are the pretty good ones. I would say they cost way more if you were to buy 30 separately. So having this entire pack is good, and then you can go back and get the different shades if you want. Like, there's like different blue shades, there's more than this, but they sell in separate packs. But this is really nice for just starting off. So hopefully I will try to use these like one day, not now, 'cause I'm kind of still drawing my friends, and I don't know if I want to use these type of markers. I don't want to ruin it. Maybe I will make a scan and try it out and see what happens, and if I like how it turns out, I can do that for all of them. But right now I'm not sure. I'm still intimidated by markers because I'm usually a pencil crayon person, so I get intimidated by really nice quality things, and I don't want to ruin these things. But also, if I mess up, I don't want to ruin my own drawings, so that's the type of stuff that I have to deal with. But yeah, one day in the future, you guys will see me use this. I will use this on my, the more of the mythical creatures and animals that I draw, I will definitely, like, the animal characters that I draw, like Shane the Harpy and stuff, I will try to use this just to, like, because those are the ones that I want to pop out more and be more cartoony, so those will have really good effect with these markers. So yeah, so I just wanted to show you this really nice set that I got, and if you guys are interested, please, like, search this company up, because they have really good sets, and it's even like the small sets with the different shades of blue and everything, those look really nice as well. So I am just amazed by how nice it is, and their cost is decent. It's not like, it's not too pricey, I would say. Their range is pretty on point, because I do know sometimes people can't afford different art materials because it's really expensive, and neither can I because I'm not the one paying for my stuff, so that's why I don't want to use my dad's money to buy really expensive stuff. But he's willing to buy the stuff, but I just want to get ones that don't cost that much, and also it's more efficient, so that way I can get more instead of just getting really expensive ones and not being able to get like at least a rainbow of colors. So yeah, so that's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I think I have a video to show you something I got from the ROM. I got this pillow, so I will show that in my next video. So I just hope you guys enjoyed this video. Yeah, I'm still drawing my friends, as I said. I might do coloring videos, I might not. Fairies, because right now I'm still drawing them. I actually, because I'm filming this in the March break, actually, during the March break, I've barely been doing anything just because I've been staying home by myself. So there's, I guess because it's so much people, there is a lack of motivation to draw everyone at once. But hopefully I finish them before March break, and then I will get to outlining and coloring. I'm not sure if I will use these or not, as I said before, but I will definitely, like, maybe test it out one day, and then for, like, I'll just scan and then test it and then see if I like it. And if I really love it, I might just use them. But I may just use pencil crayon. So, yeah. So. I really love how their markers look, like this gradient of the color on here and the logo. It's really cool. I'm simply enjoying this, and the fact that I think you can refill is really nice. So yeah, so that's it for this video. Bye.